All right, thanks, Roger. Well, ahead of this weekend's big Beach to Beacon 10K race, crews were out this morning painting the start line in Cape Elizabeth. The annual event helps raise money for a nonprofit agency, and this year, the proceeds go to Day One in South Portland, which gives substance abuse prevention and treatment for kids. Today's race finishes at Portland headlight inside of Fort Williams Park. And for many of the hundreds of people who will be at the park, they'll notice Fort Williams is undergoing a significant facelift. Work is well underway on the first phase of what organizers are calling the Arboretum Project at Fort Williams Park. Live at 6, News 8, Steve Minich joins us from inside the park with all the details. Steve?
Well, Tracy, anybody who knows this park knows how amazing it is to be standing in this spot a good 50 yards from the cliff walk and look out and see water. For years, this entire area was overgrown with invasive plants, but thanks to a privately funded project, well, as you can see, once again, the views are spectacular.
Well, it's pretty thrilling because these views have been choked off by invasive species for years. So
Lynn Schaefer has helped spearhead this project more than 5 years in the planning. Since early spring, dozens of volunteers, and now these professionals have cleared this site, the first of 15 the Arboretum Committee hopes to restore.
Get rid of the invasives that are taking over the park and reestablish natural landscapes that are healthy environments for all the animals that like to live here.
And the project will be paid for with private money. Already, the committee's collected more than $150,000. It's work the town says had to be done, but could not afford to with public funds.
It assists us in that endeavor. It's something that we need to do, but with all of the funding needs in the community, obviously it helps if there's private funding on a project like this. So.
It's a historic spot.
Military historian Ken Thompson says this project thrills him, since suddenly much of the historic fort has come back into view, exposing areas the public hasn't seen in years.
You could be 10 feet away from it in the summertime and not know it's there. And by cleaning away areas like here, you restore this to the appearance of when it was a fort.
But clearing is just the beginning. Lynn Schaefer believes maintaining the site will ultimately prove most important, ensuring these views never get choked off again.
So that we're leaving a legacy for future generations.
The committee continues to raise money. In fact, it is a finalist for a $50,000 grant from Toms of Maine. And also, if you would like to become a volunteer and help out with this project, the next volunteer day here is August 27th. In Cape Elizabeth, Steve Minich, News 8.